Bruce!
Tim, welcome back. Good to see you too. Anybody else back?
Yeah.
Perfect conditions.
Yeah, exactly. Kind of just keep tree direction. Right. Don't go left of that tree. Kind of stay right here. All right, next to you guys can go.
It's like we got a lot of people with the same information. information, aren't you?
We'll probably be doing a slight up. Is there anyone here who wants, like, hey, I've got my brother or sister or friend here that wants to split the same group with them that's here? No one. Okay, good. All right. Raise your hand. One, two, three. Let's have you three gentlemen. Let's have you come up here next to this gentleman, and let's have you guys form one group. Okay? Oh, really? And how many people are interested in hiking right away? One, two, three. Why don't we take those three and make them a group? Boom. And who are the other two? You guys become a group. All right. You, sir, and you, ma'am? All right. And you guys become a group. An amphitheater to the Thunder Chairlift. Head up and we'll start talking our talk.
Cool.
All right, here we go.
You'll definitely want to zip up for this.
Yeah, I know what we're going to do.
So, all this stuff, do you have your phone with you?
Yes.
Is it accessible? So I'm going to have you pull that out for just a second. And you have a stopwatch app on it or something?
Yep. Okay.
Okay, so when I start sliding, start it. As soon as I stop, that's when you stop it.
Okay.
All right. I slid 40 or 50 feet, and that was from a kind of sitting on my bum. So if you think of, if you're actually already skiing 20 miles an hour down something, 50 miles an hour down something, how far you could potentially slide. You know, if you get stuff like these cliffs over here, trees, rocks below you, constantly that up. So we're just gonna learn how to stop ourselves and what to do if we do start, we do start falling. The big thing to remember, this heals, this doesn't. So making sure that you get your feet down below you before anything. And so if you start kind of doing the Superman slide. So you saw, first thing I did, I started sitting on my bum, rolled over onto my stomach, got my toes and my elbows in. This stuff is great at keeping us warm and dry. When we put it on the snow, it's like you're wearing a toboggan. It gets, you just accelerate. Most people's reaction is this. You go on to the hip, and all you do, you can't get your boot in. So have you guys both come on over here, and just kind of get flat on the snow, get your toes in like this. So the more you can get your weight on smaller surface area, the more pressure you're gonna have. So trying to get on your toes and up on your elbows, almost kind of like you're doing a plank, and you can feel all that weight. We don't want to be up too high here, because then if our toes catch, what's gonna happen?
You're gonna go.
I'm gonna go completely over the top. So almost sitting like a plank. So just kind of sit down, if you're slowing down, lift your feet up a little bit. Nice. And now roll over on your bum. Start getting a little bit of speed. And that's even gonna roll over. And roll over. Nice. And you can see how effective it is.
Yeah.
But you see, as soon as you roll onto your bum, how fast you start sliding. So being able to stop that. I'll have you guys practice. We'll grab your speed, we'll bring your feet down so you don't have to walk back up. But just kind of like lay up flat on your back. Go down on your stomach head first and see if you can get turned around.
So head down on your stomach.
Yeah, like a Superman slide. Nice, there you go.
It works.
Alright, now on your back, head down. This one's actually easier. So head down the hill on your back. There you go, Liam. Nice. All right, why don't you come and grab their skis? Crossover, like this. So you can get your foot. Or another way, particularly in powder, you saw when I was up there doing it.
Stick it up.
Doing that. And then the tricky part of this one is just that part. So both super handy ways. I've seen people struggle for a half hour trying to get their skis on. And then with the uphill one, it's actually pretty easy. Again, getting the ski parallel, just make sure this, your downhill leg is pretty far away from the ski. And then it makes it easy just to step into it. So get, yeah, kick a nice platform with that boot. There you go. Push, 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 push. There you go. Step over. Big out. Remember, you gotta keep your boot parallel to the boot sole parallel to the ski. There you go.
Good.
Nice, good job.
That was easier.
All right, William, we start getting yours on.
Yeah, you wanna slide down a little bit, Nick? I don't want
to. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Let me get out of the way.
Like the best angle.
There you go, perfect. Good job. Let's go down to the flat right down here, get off the run. That you step in there and you get it on correctly. I don't want it pulling off halfway down the run. Let's head down. We'll go back up Thunder. We're gonna get up, kind of head over toward the Selvet area, and we'll start talking about kind of what, why we do some of the things we do when we're in the ski. Here we go. Thank you.
will go across, but you want to be kind of careful with that. You guys can drop if you want. We're just chatting.
Okay.